Hello, men and brethren, good afternoon to you all worldwide. Wherever you are, I want you to listen and join me today as you read the Word of God. Happy day to you all. Before you go to your place of work today, your place of business, do you have time? Do you make a time to read the Word of God? So, join me as we read the Word of God. Today, I'm reading from the book of Matthew, chapter 1. Matthew, chapter 1. The book of the generation of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Abraham begot Isaac, and Isaac begot Jacob, and Jacob begot Judas and his brethren. Verse 3. And Jesus begat Phares and Zerah of Tamar, and Phares begat Esrom, and Esrom begat Aram, and Aram begat Aminadab, and Aminadab begat Nahshon. Nahshon begat Salmon, and Salmon begat Booz of Rechab, and Booz begat Obed of Ruth, and Obed begat Jesse. Verse 6. And Jesus begat David the king, and David the king begat Solomon of her that had been the wife of Urias. And Solomon begat Rehoboam, and Rehoboam begat Abia, and Abia begat Asa. Verse 8. And Asa begat Jehoshaphat, and Jehoshaphat begat Joram, and Joram begat Uzzias, and Uzzias begat Jotham, and Jotham begat Ahaz, and Ahaz begat Ezekias. Verse 10. And Ezekias begat Manasseh, and Manasseh begat Amon, and Amon begat Josias, and Josiah begat Jeconias and his brethren, about the time they were carried away to Babylon. Verse 12. And after they were brought to Babylon, Jeconias begat Salathiel, and Salathiel begat Zerubbabel, and Zerubbabel begat Abiud, and Abiud begat Eliakim, and Eliakim begat Azor, and Azor begat Sadok, and Sadok begat Akim, and Akim begat Eliud. Verse 15. And Eliud begat Eleazar, and Eleazar begat Matan, and Matan begat Jacob, and Jacob begat Joseph, and the husband of Mary, of whom was born Jesus, who is called Christ. Verse 17. So all the generations from Abraham to David are 14 generations, and from David until the carrying away into Babylon are 14 generations, and from the carrying away into Babylon unto Christ are 14 generations. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise: when as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Verse 19. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privily. Verse 20. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. Verse 21. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Verse 22. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying. Verse 23. Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and that shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife. Verse 25. And knew her not till she brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. Praise the Lord. So, make time to read the Bible, and the Lord shall bless you, and spirit shall mighty bless. Remember, verse 21 of Matthew chapter 1. And he shall bring forth a son, and then shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. So Jesus came to save us from our sins. John chapter 14. Verse 6, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man come unto the Father but by me. So, men and brethren, as you read the word of God, you shall receive illumination. The word of God will illuminate us, preserve us, help us, and love the Lord the more. As you do so daily, your life shall never remain the same. I thought I told you in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.